So in the last class we have seen the divisibility rule of 4 and 8. Yes. Now in today's class we'll see the divisibility rule by 11. Now here I will read out what is lesson. A given number is divisible by 11 if the difference between the sum of the digits at odd places and the sum of the digits at even places is either 0 or divisible by 11. So if I read like this means you won't understand. So we'll go with an example, then it will be clear. Now here is an example. Is 1221 divisible by 11? So as I told you, first you have to write what is the given number. So the given number is, the given number is what? 1221. Here what is said? The difference between sum of the digits at odd places. Odd or even means here you just give names, numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. From right side onwards you have to name them as 1, 2, 3, 4. So you just circle the odd places or even places. Now here I am circling the odd places. You just circle the odd places. Okay? Odd places means the numbers which are there in odd numbers. 1, 3. Now what you have to find? Sum of the digits at odd places. So whatever values are there in odd places, you have to add up. So write down here. Sum of the digits at odd places. So what are the digits at odd places? In ones place, 1 is there. 1 plus. In odd place, 3. In 3, what is that? 2. So you add up. 1 plus 2, how much is? 3. Now similarly, the sum of the digits at even places. What are the values in even places? 2 and 4? 2 and 1. So write down here. Sum of the digits at even places. So what are the values which are there in even places? 2 and 4 are even. So what are they? 2 and 1. So you add up 2 plus 1. How much? 3. Now what you have to find? The difference between sum of the digits at even places and sum of the digits at odd places. Difference means what you have to do? You have to subtract. So now you find the difference. When you subtract these two, so 3 minus 3 gives you what? 0. Now here, read out the definition. If the difference between these two is either 0, it should be either 0 or it should be a multiple of 11, or else it should be divisible by 11. So these two conditions it must satisfy. So anyway, we are getting the difference as 0. So if you are getting 0 means I can say that this number is divisible by 11. So write down. Hence, the given number is divisible by 11. So this is how you have to find. So most of you students will get confused over here. So you have to give numbering from right to left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, how many you will be having? So for that you have to give. And you have to circle only the numbers which are there in odd places. You add up the odd places digits. You add up the digits at even places. Now find the difference. So if you are getting 0 means it is divisible by 11. Suppose if you are getting any multiple of 11, 22, 33 means then also it is divisible by 11. Now we will see one more example. Is 6535 divisible by 11 or not? So write down first what is given. So the given number is 6535. Okay. Now you write 1, 2, 3, 4. also odd number. Now you write sum of the digits at odd places. So what are they? 5 and 5. So 5 plus 5 gives you how much? 10. Okay. Now you write down sum of the digits. Sum of the digits at even places. Even places. So what are the digits that are even? 3 and 6. Now you add up 3 plus 6 gives you 9. Now what is our next step? You have to find the difference. So write down difference. Now you subtract 10 minus 9 gives you 1. Now is it divisible if you are getting 1 means? No. So why? Because 1 means not divisible by 11. So write down. Hence, what is the given number? The given number 6535 is not divisible by 11. Dear children, so this is how you have to check whether a given number is divisible by 11 or not. Now we can copy. I hope you people have understood the divisibility by 11. Now we'll see some more examples. Okay. Now here I have taken one number. So what I told you, first you have to circle the odd places. So write down the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you circle the odd places. 1, 3, 5, 7. So what you have to do? You have to add up the digits at odd places. So what are they? You just add 8 plus 9 plus 9 plus 9. So how much? 9 plus 9 plus 9. So 9 into 3, 27. So 27 plus 8 gives you 35. So 9 plus gives you 35. So this is the sum at odd places. Now you find the sum at even places. So what are the even digits, even values? 0 plus 1 plus 0 plus 1. So how much? 1 plus 1? 2. So now what you have to find difference? So find the difference. 35 minus 2 gives you 33. Now you have to check. Is 33 divisible by 11? Yes. How many times? 11 threes are 33. So 33 is a multiple of 11. So it is divisible. So in this way you have to check. Now we will see one more example. Now, again the same process you have to follow. You have to write like this. Then it will be very clear for you. Now, circle the odd places. Add up 8 plus 5 plus 8. Gives you how much? 8 plus 5, 13 plus 8 gives you 21. Now, so 21 means, is it divisible by 11? No. So why? Because 11 twos are 22. You won't get 21. So it is not divisible.
Hello.
Sorry, 1. Now you add up the even numbers. 6 plus 3 gives you how much? 9. Find the difference. 21 minus 9 gives you how much? 12. Yes? Now is 12 divisible by 11? No, it is not divisible. Okay? Now we'll see one more example. Now 1331. Circle here. Now add up. Sum of odd places, 1 plus 3 gives you 4, and sum of even digits is equal to 3 plus 1 gives you 4. So difference is equal to 4 minus 4, which is equal to 0. So as I said, what is the rule? If you are getting the difference at 0 means it is divisible. So 1331 is divisible by 11. Yes. is divisible. So I have shown you three examples where you got the multiple of number, where you got the difference as zero, and one which is not divisible. I hope you people have clear. So you take your own number, 5 digit, 6 digit, your own number you take and start doing whether is it divisible by 11 or not. You have to do more and more practice on this, then only you will get it. Clear, children? Thank you.